phone call, you can have all of your problems solved. All you need to do is make just one phone call to the NACMU group. And by doing that, you'll have advantage of all of these services because the NACMU group is an association of all of these professions. And they'll take care of all your financial planning. And of course, you may ask, well, why would you want to do that in the first place? Well, of course, the reason why you contact the NACMU group is because they could make you money. And so it's like a coloring book thing, but basically I've added that. The other thing I did is I added on the back here this little holder, which you fill full of loonies. Say, well, how much money could they make? And then at the end you could like dump all the change up in a bunch of loonies and stuff. It's really dramatic and noisy. So it's just an example of taking a standard trick, a coloring book, and saying, how could I recreate this for my own needs? If you do gospel magic, you can do the same thing. If you do corporate magic, you can do that. Just come up with a theme, and then you just look at it the way a coloring book is constructed, which is pretty simple, and using a printer or whatever, just come up with it. I've had the pleasure over the last while of being the Disney Saturday Afternoon Magician. And so what I've done is I've taken a lot of the Disney themes and incorporated in them. It's all just like photocopies of Timon and Pumbaa, you know, and coloring books with those or whatever. It works fantastic. One other thing, this is a prototype as well, so I'll excuse the production quality of it, but this illustrates how you can take standard tricks and turn them into trade show tricks. Okay. We have here three cards, and I'll turn it this way so everybody can see it. One of them represents that valuables. Now say that's on the top floor of your house, you've got valuables. And on the next level, the main floor, you also have more valuables. Unfortunately, what you didn't realize is that in the basement there was a burglar. So when you went out to the opera, it wasn't just valuables left home in your house, but an unwanted person. Now you don't know where he would be in your house either. He might be in the basement taking some of your valuables. He might be on the top floor taking some more of your valuables. He might be on the main floor taking some of your valuables. The important thing to remember is that in your house, there is a burglar. And he will start in the basement, he'll work his way through the house. He'll go to the top floor, he'll go to the main floor until all your valuables are gone. Now, if some of your valuables were there and a burglar is here, do you know where your other valuables would be? No, they'd be in the pawn shop. Because you did not use Honeywell Controls alarm systems. Okay, so you're appealing to their sense of loss with sort of a kicker punchline. Now, I made up a similar set for FireTech security systems, and they came up with a bracelet for ambulatory patients in extended care facilities. And a lot of these patients, they're suffering from senility or whatever. So they'll sometimes wander out of buildings, you know, and they'll get lost in neighborhoods, right? And so with these bracelets, they can track where they are. One central location shows where every single patient is in the entire facility. Now, in order to dramatize that, I came up with these three cards. One says here, one says there, and then says there's a patient here, 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 there, there, there. Go through the standard thing. Then, you know, if there's a patient here and there's a patient there, do you know where the other patient is? I got mine always in the parking lot. Because you don't have this system. Once again, you appeal to the sense of loss. Okay. And I'm sure most of you would recognize the moves from Jim West's Color Monte, a classic magic effect, which probably all of you have at home. And so by taking those moves and applying a totally different presentation to it, you can come up with something that's suitable for a trade show. Now, when we do this for a trade show, we get the cards custom printed, though. I mean, with that one here. See, this is an example of it. You can pass this around if you want. That's a foil stamp, just like on Jim West's Color Monte. And the company will pay us for those, you know, buck a card or whatever. And then, of course, you have to absorb any cost in printing them, you know, 3 cents or whatever. But